It's important to understand the responsibilities of the information security officer. The ISO is a role, not necessarily a separate person, but it's a role within an organization that is responsible for communicating all risks to upper management. The communication process is crucial because the security policy, which comes from upper management, must be satisfied. So you need the downward communication channel and the upward communication channel as well for the ISO to let upper management know how things are going. The ISO is also responsible for the budget for all information security activities and ensures the development of many different types of documents, such as policies, procedures, all the baselines, standards, and guidelines. The ISO is not necessarily the person or even the role that accomplishes all these tasks, but the one that holds the responsibility to upper management to ensure that these tasks are indeed followed through and accomplished. The ISO additionally has responsibilities for developing the security awareness program, as well as understanding the business objectives. If your security policy does not match business objectives or meet the business objectives, then it's not going to satisfy upper management. So the ISO has to have a good feel for what's being done from a business perspective and what's being done from a security perspective as well. The ISO is also responsible for establishing security metrics and ensuring compliance with government regulations. The specific regulations which apply to your organization will be different from the specific regulations that apply to any other organization. So it's up to the ISO to be on his or her toes and make sure they understand the business objectives as well as the regulatory environment in which the organization operates.